So as you can see from the title of the video, we are making a sleep mask today and I'm jumping right to start the video. No time to waste. All right, so I have my pattern paper here and I'm folding it into two, as you can see. Okay, by the way, my name is Dami and this is Dami Dimension. Hit the like button if you like this video. Okay, so after folding my paper into two, I went ahead to draw a square box on the paper, and the size of this box is 4 inches long, all right, and 4 inches wide as well. They have each side are 4 inches. All right, after having this, then you want to find the midpoint of this bottom line. Okay, right here is my midpoint, and once you have that point, I'm going to come to this corner and I'm going to be going up by 1/2 inch. All right, so keep those points. Okay, now we have 2 points. Next, I'll come to this edge and I am going to be coming up by 1.5 inch, just like that. And again, I will return to that corner again and I will go in diagonally. All right, I will go in diagonally by 0.75. Okay, and about the last point, I guess I'll come to this corner and I am going to go in diagonally by 1 inch. So I have 5 points in total, and I'm just going to go ahead and connect these points together with a gentle curve that looks something like this. And as you can see, at first I used my pencil to connect those points so that I can make corrections to any line that I'm not satisfied with. And once I'm satisfied, I went ahead to use my marker to bring it out. Then I'm adding 1/2 inch seam allowance all around the pattern. So then I'm going ahead to cut it out. And the reason why I folded my paper in the beginning is by the time that I open it up, I will have a complete sleep mask like this. So that's basically the pattern. Simple, super duper simple. And these are the fabrics I'm going to be making use of. You can literally use any kind of fabric you want. This is going to be for the outer part, and I will use the satin for the inner. And I need a wadding to pad it. Okay, I have two types of wadding here just to show you. You see, this one is kind of fluffy and it's thicker, and this one is not fluffy, it's slim. As you can see, you can pretty much use any one, but I'm using this fluffy one just because I want that fluffy soft thickness, you know. But if you're using the light one, make sure you double it. So I cut my about the piece of fabric that I need, I place my pattern, and I simply cut it out. Then I have these two pieces cut out. So I marked the allowance on it, and I'm also using that piece to also cut out my wadding as well. So once I was done cutting the wadding, this is what I have. Next is my elastic band, and the elastic band I'm using is 15 inches long. If your head is bigger or your hair is fuller, you can add 1/2 inch to that. So now it's time to stitch them. So I have my wadding placed on the table. I place my fabric right side facing up, and then I'm pinning down my elastic band on top of it, just as you can see. Okay, and I will make sure I keep my elastic out of the way. Then I'll place the second fabric on top of it, right side facing the one I already have on the table. All right, after pinning it down, I'll take it to my machine and stitch from here all the way and stop here, leaving an over turning inside out. And before we move on, I'm just going to quickly talk about the sponsor of today's video.
Today's video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning platform where millions of creative minds like you and me come together to learn new things on different topics to become more creative. There are thousands of lessons on Skillshare, topics that covers illustration, fashion design, photography, or whether you want to learn video editing, video making, art, graphic design, or maybe you want to learn about YouTube, how to start your own YouTube channel and be successful. There are lessons on how to grow on Instagram, how to grow on social media. There are lessons on marketing, craft, productivity. Did I just say marketing? I'm sure that is communicating to someone already. This was actually what captivated me on Skillshare. I was taking a particular lesson by Gary, And guys, that lesson literally took me back to my drawing table because I was able to get valuable tips that can help me to grow my online business despite the competition that is going on today. You can apply the knowledge in your fashion business as well. What makes this difference is the fact that it's focused solely on learning. That means there are not going to be ads bothering you. Despite the numerous things you can learn on Skillshare, it is affordable. It's just $10 per month for an annual subscription. And guess what, guys? I have a good news for you. The first 1,000 people to click on the link in my description box is going to get a free trial to the premium membership. If I were you, I won't let this opportunity pass me by. So head on to the description box and grab yourself the free trial opportunity.
All right. So once we're done stitching that, this is what I have. As you can see, that opening. Before I flip it, I'm just going to trim off the wadding excess because it's important to do this, otherwise it's not going to come out flat and nice. And I'm also going to trim off the excess of the fabric as well, just because I don't need it. And I am giving it a notch so that by the time I flip it to the right side, it comes out flat and nice. So through here, I'm going to be flipping it to the right side in between the two fabrics, okay? Then I have this, and pretty much the final thing to do is to close up this opening. Now, some people can top stitch, but I don't like to do that. I have a video on how to do a clean invisible hand stitch. I'll post the link so you can check that out and you know how to do that. As you can see, I have a matching scrunchie, which I have a video on the channel, or it's coming up, so watch out for that. I hope you like this video. Please give it a like and let's meet in my next video. Bye.